Hello beautiful peeps, this is Chris from Recombo and I'm here with one of my most anticipated smartphones of 2019, the Google Pixel 3a. Offers the same smart camera tech and that nice compact form of the full fat Pixel 3, but at a much lower cost. This bad boy will cost you just £399 as opposed to the £739 that the Google Pixel 3 certainly cost when it first came out. So let's give it a full unboxing, check it out, and don't forget for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech to pop subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Cheers! So there is the actual phone itself. We have the black model. It also comes in white and ever so slightly purplish or whatever it's called. But let's just check out what you get in the rest of the box as well before we actually dive into the phone itself. So a neat little Google pouch. As the icon might have given away slightly, you get a porky pin device. Quite a stubby little number there. Lovely stuff. User guides, naturally. And of course, a bit of Team Pixel sticker action and some boring warranty gumph. We also have, of course, naturally, a bit of Type-C USB cable action, Type-C to Type-C. And you also have, same as with the original Pixel 3 as well, it's properly wedged in there, but basically Type-C to full-size USB converter as well, which is always good to see. And I'm guessing in here, just a wild stab in the dark, it is a 3-pin plug. There we go. So you're all set for your charger needs. No cheapy headphones or anything bundled in there, but you know what? For the new low asking price, I am not going to grumble about that one little bit. Sweet as a nut, mate. So that is the Pixel 3a box for itself. And of course, we have got the official Pixel 3a case as well. So we will slap that on in a sec just to show it off. I'm not actually going to use that for my full review because I want to actually test out the durability of the phone itself. How do you actually get into this bloody thing? Ah, invisible sticker, mate. That's what your problem is. There we go. Let's just peel that off and then hopefully this will just push or pull or something. There we go. Right, there is the cover itself. It's a nice fabric cover. So it's a very different texture to the Pixel, especially good if you don't like that sort of smooth glass finish, very slippery. As you can see, that will just slip onto your Pixel phone like so. Adds a fair bit of girth to it. That is quite a chunky monkey now. But as you can see, obviously, exposes the rear-mounted fingerprint sensor, the camera tech, and you've got your buttons and everything where you need them too. Let's get this bad boy loaded on. We'll take a tour of the hardware as well. So as you can see, very similar design to the original Pixel 3. Quite compact in nature. It's a 5.6 inches, so fits beautifully in the hand. Really does feel nice indeed, especially compared with all those bloody 6-inch devices that we've been playing with. In fact, these days, 6 inches feels pretty damn miniature. It's the same polycarbonate finish and everything as well, so it's got this nice smooth finish to it, but as you can see, it's a two-tone effect as well. You've got the sort of matte style finish, almost looks metallic here down below, and then up at the top around the camera lens, you get this shiny finish instead. And as I said before, available in black, white, and a sort of a slightly purple tint, which is actually more white. It actually looks slightly more blue when you see it in certain lights, but it does have a slight tint to it. And the nice things about the white and the purple models is you get a nice poppy power button as well, a nice colorful power button. Unfortunately, you don't get that on the black model. It's a very straightforward, some might say even slightly boring design, but there you go. One of the other changes of the Pixel 3a compared with the original Pixel 3 is the fact that it's no longer water resistant as well, in order to obviously trim costs a bit. So no biggie, but hopefully it should still be fairly splash resistant, so take it out and about in the rain. Hello, fellow UK people, and hopefully it won't break on impact. So a little bit more about that screen as well. It's a 5.6 inch, as mentioned before. It's an OLED panel, full HD plus resolution as well. So reasonably crisp. It's 2220 by 1080 pixel resolution, of course, because it is a more compact screen as well. That does look nice and crisp. We get in there nice and close, just get that focus working. And as you can see, the tiny text, perfectly legible, no individual pixel action there. The icons are nice and sharp and everything as well, so hopefully should do the job nicely. And you do actually get the active edge sensors built in to the Pixel 3a as well. They haven't ditched that for the more budget model, so as you can see, just squeeze it and you can get the assistant called up in a jiffy. You can change the sensitivity and everything. Unfortunately, you can't change what it actually calls up. It's just the assistant, basically. But never mind, always nice to have if you use the bit of the GA man. That's the actual software. No prizes for guessing that it is, of course, the latest version of Android, Android Pie. As you can see there, Android version 9. And as this is a Pixel 4, and the Pixel 3 is supported for 3 years for security and OS updates. So great news if you want something to be using it for the long term. It's not going to be neglected or anything like that. The security is as strong as ever. You get all your passwords and everything encrypted on the chip itself. And of course, that rear-mounted fingerprint fingerprint sensor as well. So we dive into the security section, wherever that may be. Go on to Pixel Imprint, you can set up your fingerprint nice and quick and easy. So let's do that with the pin. And then send it up is nice and quick. Just keep on tapping that bad boy over and over again until it's all done. And then when you want to unlock the Pixel 3a, just tap your finger to that sensor, and as you can see, boom, straight into the desktops. Nice and easy. Unfortunately, just like the standard Pixels, there's no kind of face recognition or anything in there. So if we're going to Smart Lock, I believe, discreetly tap in my pin. And there's, yeah, as you can see there, just the on-body detection. There is no sign of any face unlock, so boo. And of course, all the usual Android Pie features are on there. A bit of digital well-being, so you can see exactly what you've been doing on your smartphone and then lament the fact that you're wasting your life 1 minute at a time on shit like Instagram. And of course, if you dive into the display, full control over the settings there. So for instance, dive into the colors, you see it's set to adaptive. If you want to just dial it down a bit, you don't have those colors really in your face, more natural hues, you can do that. There's of course a bit of always on display action and all of that, so yeah, great stuff. In terms of if you want a nice bit of stock Android, obviously the Pixels, you cannot go wrong. And can I just say, I'm already loving just how compact this thing is, just how easy it is to reach up for that notifications bar. You don't even need a one-handed mode on this thing. It's nice and dinky, lovely stuff. So what is actually running the show? Well, it's a Snapdragon 670 chipset on here, backed by 4 gigs of RAM. So obviously you don't get that super premium Snapdragon tech, the 845 that you got on the Pixel 3. But you know what, so far seems perfectly nippy, helped along with the fact that it's stock Android, you don't have a heavy overlay on there for it to support or anything like that. So we reckon it should be a nice nippy experience, as you can see there, it's flicking through. No stammers or stutters so far. We'll of course be giving this a full review, so stay tuned for that for more in-depth coverage. As for the battery tech, I was surprised, it's actually a 3000 milliamp cell stuffed in here, so slightly bigger than the original Pixel 3, which had a 2915 milliamp cell, so hopefully should prove all day battery life no problem. Definitely the original Pixel was very solid on the battery life, XL model even so, because it's a much bigger battery. And as you can see, you've got the usual adaptive battery mode, you can show your battery percentage, and of course it's got the smart battery monitoring as well, so you can actually turn that on, and that just helps you to cull any apps that are running in the background and sapping your juice, the cheeky wee buggers. So that's good as well. And actually, before I forget, we'll dive back into the Pixel 3 is settings. We've got the storage, as you can see there. You've got 64 gigs as standard. There is not going to be a 128 gig model, at least not at launch. So 64 gigs as standard for that £399 price point. Of course, there's no expandable storage. There's no support for micro SD memory cards, but you do at least get unlimited Google photo storage. So as long as you don't mind uploading all your photos to the cloud and then just deleting them locally, then you can snap away as merrily as you like. No worries. Also, on the battery front, it's worth pointing out there's no wireless charging support, as you'd probably expect for a £400 Pixel that's been culled in order to save cost, but you still get the relatively fast 18-watt charging. And also, definitely worth pointing out up top here, look at this bad boy, it's a 3.5mm headphone jack. Hello, haven't seen you in a little while. So yeah, if you just want to plug your phones directly in, not have to worry about relying on Bluetooth, job done, via that Type-C USB, so that's pretty good. All of which excitement brings us onto the camera tech, and of course, thankfully, as we all hoped and prayed for, you get the same 12.2 megapixel rear mounted sensor as you got on the full-sized, full-fat Pixel 3. And that's once again f1.8 apertures using the Sony IMX363 sensor. If you dive on into the camera app, you'll see the setup is basically the same as well. The only thing is they have removed the Pixel Visual Core from the Pixel 3a and the Pixel 3a XL, again in order to cut costs. But according to Google, at least apparently, it's just as capable without that core, thanks to some updates to the software smarts behind it all. Certainly looking forward to giving it a full test, so stay tuned for our in-depth Pixel 3a camera review. But as you can see, you've got your standard camera modes, you can snap away with that, full HDR support and everything. You've got the motion controls, you can control the color temperature, the brightness, that's about it as far as the manual controls go. You've got your full portrait mode. Video wise, you can shoot up to full HD at 30 or 60 frames per second, or also 4K resolution video as well. Go on to the settings, I've got it set to 4K at the moment, just dial it down to 1080p. If you go into the video mode, you'll see that you do actually have the ability to swap between 30 or 60 frames per second right here on the main screen, but no controls over the resolution. You do still have to go to more, go to settings, scroll down. Kind of annoying, but maybe they'll fix that in an update. But the image stabilization, I've already had a brief test of that. Still solid, even at that 4K level. It definitely looks very strong on the photo and the video chops. And if we dive into the more section, of course you've got a few bonus modes in there, including good old night sight, which appeared as an update for the original Pixel 3s. Very good, not quite as strong as the Huawei stuff, the Huawei night modes, unfortunately in some circumstances, mostly cityscapes, but still very impressive indeed, considering it is just a software update that appeared on those smartphones after the fact. And you do now also get a full time-lapse option as well here in the video. And of course, you also get an 8-megapixel front-facing camera as well. It's f2.0 aperture. You don't have the dual lens front-facing camera again to cut costs. Not massively bothered about that because this is still quite a wide-angle lens, as you can see there, just stepping back at full reach. You've got a good amount of space behind you to capture any, you know, touristy shenanigans, get a few mates around you. You'll have to snuggle in a bit more maybe compared with the original Pixel 3, but if you're all friends, then it's all good. And you can again switch to portrait mode as well in order to shoot a nice portrait selfie. Woo! And again, the Google software smarts on the portrait mode is absolutely stunning. Who needs two lenses, eh, when one does the job nicely? And also, unfortunately, this isn't quite the updated version of the camera software, but apparently the final version will also allow you to take a photo with that selfie camera just by giving it a little kiss. Mwah! Like so, a little pout. And that will take a lovely pouty Instagram shot for you. Great stuff. And that right there in a nutshell is the sexy new Pixel 3a. Definitely, as I say, one of my most anticipated smartphones of 2019, just because it's great to see Google do more affordable handsets again. Not since the Nexus range have they really done that, and we love some of those Nexus phones, like the Nexus 5. And the fact that it's a compact phone as well, so, so lovely. Great to see. So it is a genuinely strong proposition, I reckon. It's the fact that it's got that excellent camera tech in there. Still, hopefully, should provide nice, smooth, everyday performance, that lovely version of stock Android Pie. You've got the long-term support of it all and everything as well. So yeah, what do you reckon? Are you tempted? Have you at least popped a semi by now? Definitely let us know in the comments down below. It'd be great to hear your thoughts. And don't forget to subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest mobile tech. Cheers, everyone. Love you.